Hello, welcome back. In this video, I'm going over health insurance and how you can take a deduction for your health insurance in any situation that you have with your small business. I must admit, this area is just massively confusing. And because of that, there's all the more confusing information online, but I've sorted it all out and I'll be breaking it down for you very simply in this video. And what the options are for how you can deduct your health insurance in your business. If you're new here, my name's Amanda. You're watching The Business Finance Coach, where I simplify things like this so that you can succeed and really feel supported by the structures and your business. Let's get started. So let's jump in to health insurance. So we'll be looking at what the health insurance deduction is, what's included, how you can actually take the deduction, and where it's deducted on the forms. And lastly, we will take a peek at my business types comparison spreadsheet template, where we'll be able to see the difference in health insurance under different business types. So first, what's included in the health insurance deduction? If we take a look at publication 535 for business expenses, and we head into chapter 6 for insurance, you'll see right here, it tells us that we can deduct any amount that we pay for medical and dental insurance, as well as long-term care insurance. Now, the long-term care insurance does have limitations, and those are explained on the next page. And this can be for you or your family. However, one thing to keep in mind is that to qualify for the deduction, you can't have been offered health insurance through a part-time job or full-time job that you have, like another job outside of your business, or if you're married and your spouse has a job through which he or she was offered health insurance and you decline it because you get your own plan thinking you're going to deduct it in the business, well, you can't deduct it if you have that option to get health insurance through another avenue. So how do you deduct health insurance premiums and these long-term care premiums? Generally, you're going to end up being paid through your business. Your business itself, generally, it's going to depend on your type of business, so we'll talk about that next. But generally, you're paid money from your business, and then you buy your personal health insurance. And so in that sort of situation, you actually take the deduction on the personal form 1040. It's a deduction for AGI, and I'm using the older tax return just because it's simpler to look at. I'll show you where this is on this year's as well. But you can see adjusted gross income. These are adjustments for AGI. These are the most beneficial adjustments. And you can check out another video that's coming out after this one about all the tax write-offs, and it breaks down all the tax write-offs, including, you know, this section in context with other sections. However, the main tax form has all of our net income from various activities, business, Schedule K-1s, rental properties, jobs, your W-2s, you know, everything up here, total income. And then we get these specific deductions for AGI. And you can see AGI here on line 37. That's a subtotal on the tax return. And so these are considered our most beneficial tax write-offs for the personal 1040. And so you can see we have a few here starting on line 27 that are all about self-employment. So self-employment tax, contributing to retirement plans, and the self-employed health insurance deduction here on line 29. And so you can deduct the entire amount of your health insurance qualified premiums here on this line. Now that's a deduction in calculating our personal income tax on our individual income tax return. When it comes to self-employment taxes or payroll taxes, because they're the same thing, but dressed up different, right? If you're an employee, you pay payroll taxes and the employer splits them with you. If you're a business owner, you could pay self-employment taxes. So just because you take a deduction here doesn't mean that you've excluded self-employment taxes. It just means that you're getting a deduction for income tax. So where is it deducted? So let's look at who gets to take this deduction for health insurance on page one of the 1040 and how is it treated under each type of business. So the first two sticky notes here, self-employment and partnership, that of course includes single member LLC and multi-member LLCs as well. They're going to be treated the same. And they are pretty much the same for taxes as well. And it's going to be the same for the health insurance deduction. You know, you're basically going for a single member LLC, self-employed, the owner. You can have insurance just set up under yourself or under the business. And you can just take the tax deduction yourself. On Schedule C, you just report the income and the expenses. If the business pays for it or you pay for it, it just doesn't matter. You report income and expenses on Schedule C. You report the deduction for health insurance on page one. Now with the multi-member LLC and partnerships, things do get a little more complicated because you are going to get your Schedule K-1 from the business and your health insurance payments need to be included under box 4A for guaranteed payments and box 14A for self-employment earnings. So that is going to mean that you essentially need to pay taxes on it and the business has to pay the premium. Now, if you have the policy set up under you and you pay the premiums, you can submit for reimbursement from the business. And remember, that's one of the things I cover in my spreadsheets for tracking your business accounting and in my program that covers that. So, you know, you can do that. You generally want to do it sparingly. You want to keep most of the business activity under the business and personal under personal, but the IRS has specifically accounted for this situation. So regardless of whether you cover the health insurance or the business needs to reimburse you. So the business can pay for it or they reimburse you. So effectively the business has paid for the health insurance premiums, and then they're reported to you under guaranteed payments here and self-employment earnings on your Schedule K-1. So essentially you're gonna report that amount as income and then you can deduct it as well. So if we take a peek back at our 1040 here, you're going to have from your Schedule K-1 on Schedule E, we can see line 17, rental, real estate, royalty, partnerships, S-corps, trust. So your guarantee payments plus your net income from the business will show here. And then you'll get to, which will include the health insurance. And then your health insurance, again, will be under line 29 for AGI. So in both of these situations, you are going to get a deduction for income tax. So you're not going to pay income tax on the amounts of your health insurance, but you are going to pay self-employment taxes, which is the 15.3%. On the flip side, you're going to get credit for paying that as well. And it's only actually on 92.35% of the total amount, not the full amount of the health insurance premium. In the S corporation, it's the same thing as with the multi-owner business. The business can set up the insurance plan, and that's probably best practice, really. But if the owner does it, the IRS has allowed for that as well. You just need to submit for reimbursement from the business for the amounts that you pay for the health insurance plan. Then the amount is included on your W-2. So this is the W-2 form that your business in the S-corp will give you along with your reasonable payment because you're an owner in the business. And so it will include on line one, the amount of your health insurance plus your wages, but your health insurance won't be included on line three or line five. And so that's a benefit. That's how you're gonna not pay payroll taxes or self-employment taxes on the amount of the health insurance. In this case, you're gonna pay income tax, but not the self-employment or payroll taxes. Now, this is one area where the corporation does very well. In the corporation, the business must set up the plan and can pay for shareholders, employee health insurance and deduct it. And it is not included in the owner's income. This is interesting. You know, I don't see a ton of corporations. Corporations generally aren't very popular. And I wouldn't let this be a reason that you say, oh, okay, we've got to go form the corporation. It is interesting. And in the past, you know, partnerships and self-employed people, they used to be able to deduct their health insurance for self-employment taxes as well. So it was removed about 10 years ago, that deduction. It was kind of off and on for a little bit and then removed. So let's take a look at my business types comparison spreadsheet template, because you certainly don't want to make a decision just based on health insurance. But if we come over here, let's start with a lower example, 91,000 in business income, 20,000 in business expenses. And then we need to choose a salary for the S-corp and C-corp. And so I'll go ahead and put in $60,000. Now, if we come down here to add in our health insurance, so for most single taxpayers, so we'll select single for the filing status, health insurance often averages $500 to $600. So that's about $6,000 a year. So I'll put that in here for health insurance. And we can, you know, see where we stand here. Right now, self-employed is saving the most taxes, then S-corp, then corporation. And that's pretty standard. When things really start to change is when this net income under the S-corp and C-corp becomes much greater. So when you have net income in the business after paying your salary, after paying all of your expenses, that's where we really see a difference. So let's go ahead and take out our health insurance for a second. Okay, so you can see if we remove the health insurance and we come down here, we actually have a bigger gap between the S-corp and the self-employed. And so that's expected, because we did get a bit of a benefit by saving self-employment taxes in the S-corp on the amount of health insurance. And I believe it brought the C-corp down as well, because in the C-corp, our business expenses are increased by our health insurance. So let's go ahead and add that back in. If I come down here, health insurance, 6,000, and then you can see it's added here. But the taxes for payroll taxes or self-employment taxes, they're less on this side because it's accommodating for removing payroll taxes from this $6,000. Now, if we come up to the C-corp, you can see our business expenses aren't $20,000 like in self-employed and S-corp. It's adding on the health insurance to the C-corp taxes. So let's try an example where, you know, the other options look more beneficial. If we go ahead and really up this number, like $150,000, $60,000 salary, $20,000 business expenses still. And now if we come down and check it out, we can see we're saving $6,000 in the S-corp and the C-corp is substantially more. The other thing we can do is look at being married, because when you're married, if you have a family plan, those average a lot more money, $1,500 a month maybe. So if we do $15,000 on the low end and we see how that impacts the calculation here, we still have plenty of extra net income in the C-corp and the S-corp. And if we look down here, we see total taxes, self-employed, $25,000 and $15,000 in S-corp. C-corp is $31,000. And I have changed the calculation on the C-corp to mandatory take out all the money. So, you know, C-corps can look differently if you don't take that in dividends. So now it looks much better. But check out my other videos where I go over the comparison spreadsheet templates and comparing. You really need to do a comparison for your situation and what you're spending on health insurance, or what you think these numbers are going to be, you know. And I wouldn't estimate too far in advance, because you can always change your business type based on where you are. So if you're just getting started and your goal is to make $1 million next year, don't put $1 million in here, right? You want to plan based on where you're at. And then you can always change it as that money comes in, and you can let other people handle it for you. You know, otherwise it can just be a form of self-sabotage, some of this stuff. None of this stuff makes you money. You gotta stay focused on what makes you money if you wanna have a successful business. Otherwise this stuff can cause all sorts of problems and be distracting. And so I know it's a fine line to learn what you need to know and learn it as you go. But now that you have me, you know, if you found this video helpful, then I'd recommend subscribing. And I hope to see you in the next video. I'd also love to hear any questions you have down in the comments below. Check out the description box for links I have to trainings and all sorts of other videos and resources that you might find useful. Give this video a like if you liked it, or share it with someone you know who might need it. And I will see you next time. Bye.